sunshine to take away the night. Reasons for every star above. There's a reason for the rainbow, beautiful and bright. In the skies of God's unfailing love. For moon of God, I'm standing in your light. Pray all the world will see. May all I do, Lord, by your name. That's the reason you make me.
Well, hello everybody. You're very welcome to the Beeline Children's Meeting tonight online. And whether you're watching from Facebook, Sermon Audio or YouTube, you're all very, very welcome. And don't forget, if you're watching on Facebook, please type into the comments and let us know that you are watching. We do already have a good wee number watching in. I'm going to actually maybe call those out now. Thank you, Stephen. We have Uncle Stephen on the comments tonight, so you keep him busy. Get your names come flooding in and we'll get your names read out. So we've got Charlie and Rose Patterson watching. We've got Jacob Lyons watching. We've got Bethany and James Russell. We've got Alice Kennedy. Paul Wilson is watching from Portadown. Rose and Micah are watching in all the way from Bangor. Amy McCullough from Warringstown. And we've got Leon and Riley Bell. Got Jenna Cooper, and Jenna, she says hi. Hello, Jenna, and thank you very much for taking the time to join with us tonight. We have Elaine Newell. You're very welcome to Elaine. It's good to have you. We've got Ronnie and Anne watching from Dundonald. And Rachel Wilson, she says, hi, Beeline team. Good to be tuning in again this week. And that's from all the Wilsons in Dundonald. We've got Faith and Noah McKee watching. And we've got James, Adam, and Lydia from Drumore. And we've got Leah and Aaron Oliver. So we've got a good wee crowd watching in already. And if you haven't already, put your name into the comments there. You make sure you put your name into the comments. Or if you're watching on YouTube, or if you're watching from Sermon Audio, and you have my mobile number, send me a wee text, and I'll receive those wee texts, and we'll get your names called out as well. So we're going to start our meeting. We tried a new chorus last week, and we're going to give it a go again this week. And we hope that you will enjoy this wee chorus. Children all around the world. There are children all around the world. Children just like me. Well, not like me, but like you, boys and girls. Children everywhere on earth, across the land and sea. And this is a lovely wee chorus, and we would like you to try and sing your best. I hope those boys and girls who were tuning in last week, I hope you maybe remember a little bit of the tune, and this week we'll be able to sing it maybe a little better. So we're going to start off. Oh, I forgot about my helper. How could I do this without a helper? I couldn't manage it all. And we've got wee Jacob Cameron tonight, and we're going to invite him to come up. Thank you so much, Jacob, for coming to give us a hand with the choruses tonight. All right, good man. Are we ready to go now? Good man.
Children all around the world, children just like me. Children everywhere on earth, across the land and sea. They need to hear that Jesus died and lives to set them free. Who will go and let them know, oh Lord, send me. There are children in my neighborhood, children like to play. Children
was really lovely. Hands up at home if you enjoyed that wee chorus. Oh, and we've got hands up here. Even as, did you enjoy that chorus, Jacob? Do you think we could do it again? Well, because it was nice and short, and we'll do it again. It is a lovely little chorus, and we'll give it another go. Well done. That was brilliant. Well done. Sorry, I'd wanted to go again. Technology and me sometimes just don't get on. But anyway, thank you very much, Jacob. You can have a wee seat now, pet. And we're going to open our meeting in prayer. And we're delighted to have Uncle George with us tonight. And he is going to open our meeting in prayer. And I'm sure, boys and girls, and mums and dads, you know the prayer drill by now. A, for arms folded. B, bow your heads, and C, close your eyes. And you just stay like that until Uncle George leads us off in prayer. Thank you very much.
Boys and girls, it's good to see you. In fact, it's not good to see you, it's brilliant to see you. Whenever I look on my phone and computer and I see all of those people who join in and those people who stay joined in, it's very, very easy for to have other things take your attention. But there's nothing like looking at God's word. There's nothing like waiting on the story of God. And maybe you're not saved. It's a good thing to wait on the Lord. It's an even better thing if you're saved to wait on the Lord. I'm wondering, in these hard times, are you waiting on the Lord? Are you reading your Bible, looking answers to prayer? And then the most important thing, to pray unto God. It's good to have a talking relationship with our Lord and Savior. And that's what we're going to do now. We're going to, A, arms folded. We're going to bow our heads and we're going to close our eyes. And we're going to talk to the King of Kings and Lord of Lords and ask for his blessing on this meeting. Oh, our Lord God and our Heavenly Father, we do thank thee all for gathering us here tonight, for to listen to God's word, for to stay in our seats, for to be captivated by every word, that, Lord God, you may fill the person who may share, Lord, the scripture tonight. Lord, moreover, for Pauline, who may rightly divide the word of God. But, Lord, even also the boys and girls, the mums and dads, the grannies and grandas that lay may have the Holy Spirit, Lord, for to listen to the wonderful things of the Word of God. And, Lord, if they do not know you as Lord and Savior, Lord, speak to them even tonight that they may be saved, that there may be a holy urgency of saying, what must I do to be saved? Have that prayer for to go up. Lord, help the team here tonight, have everything that may go together here, Lord, that it may be blessed of thee, owned by thee, that souls may be saved, backsliders may be restored, and the people of God, even the little ones that's born again, may be built up in thy most holy faith. We ask it in and through the name of our Lord Jesus Christ and Savior. Amen.
Thank you very much, George, for opening in prayer. We've got some more names to read out here. The names are really flooding in tonight, which is absolutely fantastic. And we want to welcome Aaron Coates to the Beeline tonight, and Annabelle, Melissa and Mason. We've got Holly, Noah and Bobby watching. And we've Auntie Sarah watching from home. And she says, so Stephen, I believe you're on the comments, so here is my essay, LOL. Hello, boys and girls. So she's been a wee bit sarcastic tonight because I know Sarah usually writes a big long essay there. So hello, boys and girls. Anne Drury is watching. It's good to have you watching in. And we've got Phoebe Cameron and Mummy watching. And they're probably watching in to see wee Jacob being the helper tonight, which is super. We've got Sylvia Dixon. And we've got Janie. And the Munchkins are watching. That's brilliant. You're very welcome to the Beeline tonight, Munchkins. We've got Margaret and Adrian Jones. Raymond and Anne, the whole way from Omagh. We've got Leah Steele. It's great to have you, Leah. Jasmine and Zach Armstrong are also watching. And David and Jennifer Crane. And Naomi Gray. It's just so lovely to have you all tuning in. And if you haven't already done so, you pop your wee name into the comments box there and we will get your name read out. Or again, if you're watching from YouTube or Sermon Audio, you could send me a wee text. If you have my number, send me a wee text and let us know that you're watching and we'll get your names read out as well. So we're going to sing another couple of courses and we're going to have Jacob to come back up again to give us a wee hand. And this next course that we're going to sing is a really well-known course. Jesus loves me, this I know, for the Bible tells me so. Little ones to him belong, they are weak, but he is strong. Yes, Jesus loves me. And how do I know that Jesus loves me? Because it tells us in the Bible. And if the Bible says it, the Bible is true. So if it says Jesus loves you, then it's true. And Jesus went the whole way to Calvary, and he suffered, and he bled, and he died. And that love was shown at Calvary when he took your sins and my sins, and he died for us. So we're going to sing Jesus Loves Me now, okay? Brilliant, and I feel that I could nearly hear you singing from here, so well done for that. Now we're going to sing an action chorus now. Wide, wide is the ocean, high as the heavens above, deep, deep as the deepest sea is my Saviour's love. This is another chorus, boys and girls, about the love of the Lord Jesus, and there's a verse in the Bible tells us about the breadth and the depth and the height, and just the love of the Lord Jesus is just never ending. And this is a lovely little chorus, and we're going to do some action. So do you think everybody at home should get on their feet for this one? I think if they stood up, they would be able to do the actions better. Do you think so? Yes, so you get up on your feet at home. We're going to do wide, wide as the ocean, high as the heaven above, deep, deep as the deepest sea is my Saviour's love. And we're going to sing this little chorus through three times. Okay, on your feet now.
Of its care.
done. Well done, Jacob. You can have a wee rest now. You've been working really hard and you can have a wee rest. Now we're going to have some announcements. I'll just get my book out here. We want to give everybody a very warm welcome to the Beeline Children's Meeting tonight. It's great to have all the boys and girls tuning in. It's great to have all the family members tuning in and all our workers tuning in and our past workers and any friends of the Beeline. You are most welcome here tonight. As I've already said, if you're watching on Facebook, YouTube or Sermon Audio, you are most welcome. If there's anybody new watching in tonight, don't be afraid to let us know. And we would love to know if there's anybody new tuning in tonight. Pop your name there into the comments box if you're watching on Facebook. Even if you're not watching this service live, but you're watching it as a recorded meeting, don't forget to let me know if you're watching so that I can give you a little present mark on our little roll sheet, because that will count towards whether you get a very special prize whenever the Beeline finishes for the session. And even if you're watching or if you're tuning in on Facebook and the courses maybe aren't being played, because I know sometimes Facebook block the courses for copyright reasons, but if you go onto YouTube or onto Sermon Audio, you will be able to hear the courses being sung there. So go and watch it. If you're watching on a repeat, watch it on those, and it means then you'll not miss out on the courses. Now on Sunday at 3 o'clock, we've got our online Sunday school. Don't forget to tune in on Sunday. I know Uncle David would just be delighted to know that you're tuning in to the Sunday school and all the Sunday school teachers as well. You give them your support and you tune in there at 3 o'clock on Sunday afternoon. And then at 4 o'clock on Sunday afternoon for the older boys and girls, we've got our Bible class with Uncle Stephen. And I know Uncle Stephen would be absolutely delighted. You don't have to be from Lurgan. You don't have to be from our own church here. This is open to any boys and girls, anybody that's tuning in. You're more than welcome to join in with the Sunday school at 3 or for the older boys and girls at 4 o'clock with Uncle Stephen at our Bible class. Don't forget to pray for the work in Uganda, boys and girls. Remember, we sponsor those little children, and we just want to keep remembering. It's a good thing to pray for our missionaries, and it would be good for you to pray for the boys and the girls in Uganda. Now, next Wednesday night, we've got a very special Easter service, and we have a guest speaker coming along. And a lot of you will know who it is, because a lot of you tune into our Explorers Club on a Tuesday night. And also the Reverend Wilson came here back in September and helped us out with a couple of our meetings. So we've got the Reverend Garth Wilson coming. He's the minister for Sandown Church. He happens to be my brother-in-law as well. So we're really looking forward to Garth coming along and taking the meeting next Wednesday night. And I'm hoping that wee Isaac will be coming too, and he can help us out with the courses next Wednesday night as well. So don't forget to tune in next Wednesday night for our special Easter service. Now, boys and girls, some of you have been busy entering our Esther challenge. And some of these lovely bags of sweets and bars of chocolate have already gone in the post to some of the boys and girls who have entered and sent back their lovely worksheets. And if you would like a bar of chocolate or a bag of sweets, they're lovely Easter ones, you do the competition. There's three different categories. We've got a category for the older boys and girls, and it's just a guide. This one says this is for P5 and up. You can do this if you're in P4, if you think that you're able to, or this adults, please do this as well. We would love you to do this, and we'll send you a bar of chocolate or a bag of chocolate as well. Don't be afraid to for you to take part too. We've got another category. This is for the P1s to P4s, but again, it doesn't matter if you don't want to do this one and you want to do the younger one again. Doesn't matter what category you do. This is just like a wee guideline. And then this is the younger one. This is for preschool and under. But again, if you're in P1 or P2 and you would rather do the colouring in, you work away. We don't mind which ones that you do. Now, I know there was a bit of difficulty for some parents downloading them from our Facebook page. So because of that, we are going to extend the closing date to the 31st of March. So it's not next week. We've given you another 2 weeks. And anybody that's finding it difficult, please don't be afraid to contact me, because I have a lot of photocopies and I can post them out. I've been posting some out to parents who've requested them. So please, that's what they're there for. Just send me a wee message through Facebook, or if you have my mobile number, send me a wee message and I'll get those posted out to you. That is not a problem. And again, there's prizes for for anybody that enters. We did get some lovely worksheets in this week. We've got some from Adam Wilson and Lydia Wilson. And we also have some from Aaron Oliver and James Wilson. And then we've got this from Jacob Lyons. So we were delighted to receive all these lovely entries. And we want to say very, very well done to all those boys and girls who have entered so far. So if you don't have my details to send your finished worksheets back, the very last slide that will be shown tonight has got my mobile number on it. It has also got my email address. So if you want to take a photograph of the worksheets or if you want to post them, send me a wee text and I can give you my address as well. But those are just the different ways that you can send those back to me and then we'll be able to get the wee prizes in the post. So that's the end of the announcements. We're going to have another chorus and we're going to ask Jacob to come back up again to help us with our next chorus. And it's the B-I-B-L-E. Does anybody at home know what that spells? The B-I-B-L-E. What does that spell? Yes, that's right. It spells the Bible. That is right. And we're going to sing this lovely chorus now. Now, we're going to read out some more comments just before we sing our next chorus. We've got more people watching in. We've got Seth and Alice watching. You're very welcome, Seth and Alice. It's great to have you. We've got wee Jake McShane watching with his mummy and daddy. You're very welcome as well. And Jack Savage, you're very welcome too, Jack, as always. We've got Uncle Daniel watching. Hands up at home. Who remembers Uncle Daniel? Uncle Daniel was on our yellow bus, our Waringstown bus, wasn't he? And Uncle Daniel moved away because he became a minister. So, but I've just set you into a little secret. You might be seeing Uncle Daniel soon. So it's lovely to have you. Daniel, thank you so much for tuning in. And boys and girls, you keep tuned. You might see Uncle Daniel soon. We've got Lorraine and Irvine Furley watching. Kenny Newell is singing along as well. That's brilliant, Kenny. Well done. Isaac and Charlie White are watching from Waringstown. We've got Jacob Newell watching. We've got great singing, Jacob, doing a great job. Sarah says, fabulous actions, Jacob. You're doing a great job tonight. Emily and Holly are watching from Waringstown. Thank you, Emily and Holly, for tuning in tonight. And Jury, she says, great work, Jacob. And Naomi Gray says, great, Jacob, as well. So you're doing a great job tonight. Thank you so much. I have a super helper here with me tonight. Everybody's really impressed with you. That's brilliant. Now we're going to sing our next chorus. It's a lovely chorus. It's become, I think, one of maybe our favourite choruses here now at Beeline Online, and it's about God's power. And you, when you're singing this lovely chorus, boys and girls, you listen and take in the words that you are singing.
Oh,
brilliant, boys and girls. Thank you so much. Jacob, you can have a little seat now, Pat. And this little chorus is really, really lovely about how it speaks about the Bible. And the Bible is God's word, and that's how God speaks to us. And it says there at the bottom about, yes, the Bible will guide me and give me strength for all my days. And you know, boys and girls, it's the best book that you could ever own. And God leads and directs through his word. And that's what we're coming to now. We're coming to God's word now. And Uncle Stephen is going to come and he's going to teach us our memory verse. So you sit up and give Uncle Stephen your best attention. Thank you very much.
Good evening, boys and girls. It's great to be with you again this evening. I just got a break from the comments there. So out of the frying pan of the fire, I think, here. So let's have a look what we've got tonight. So it's another verse. I think it's the new one. And it's found in Mark chapter 10 and the verse 14, and it says, Jesus said, suffer the little children to come unto me, and forbid them not, for of such is the kingdom of God. Now, we're going to break it up so you're not doing everything at once, give you a bit of a chance to get it tonight. So we're going to do the first part. Jesus said, suffer the little children to come unto me. Now, there's one very important thing I have to tell you before we start. One very important thing. If you hear nothing else that I say tonight, take note of this. That's the third word in that verse. It says, Jesus said, suffer. Does that mean that Jesus wants little children to suffer, to be in pain and agony? No, it doesn't. Not at all. What this word means, this is an old word, and it means allow or let them come. So it means Jesus said, let the little children come unto me. Allow the little children to come unto me. It doesn't mean that Jesus wants anybody to suffer. It means he wants them to come unto him. So the word suffer, I want you to remember this tonight, is that means that allow them to come on to me. So let's have a go after two, and we'll begin by saying the verse at the bottom, Mark chapter 10, verse 14, and then we'll begin the verse. So after two, one, two. The Bible says in Mark chapter 10, verse 14, Jesus said, suffer the little children to come on to me. Now that's not too difficult. There's only 10 words. So what I'm going to do is we're going to have a countdown from 10. Not 10 seconds, but 10 words. And every time, I'm going to take one away. Just to make it. I like making things hard. There's no point making it easy for you. So let's see. We're on 10 at the moment. We're down to 9, down to 8. So after 2, 1, 2. The Bible says in Mark chapter 10, verse 14, Jesus said, suffer the little children to come unto me. So we're on 8. Now we're down to 7, 6, 5. After 2, 1, 2. The Bible says in Mark chapter 10, verse 14, Jesus said, suffer the little children to come unto me. So we're on 5, 4, 3, 2. After 2, 1, 2, the Bible says in Mark chapter 10, verse 14, Jesus said, suffer the little children to come unto me. Two left, one. I like the way I've kept the dots in there for you, as I'm too good to you, so I am. After 2, 1, 2, the Bible says in Mark chapter 10, verse 14, Jesus said, suffer the little children to come unto me. Good job. I'm sure you all did that brilliantly at home. So we'll say it after two one last time before we finish. I think you've got a good grasp of that, and we'll add more onto it next week. So after two, one, two. The Bible says in Mark chapter 10, verse 14, Jesus said, suffer the little children to come unto me. Good job.
Thank you very much, Stephen. That was great. And well done, boys and girls, for getting that at home. That was really, really good. And yes, as Uncle Stephen said, we're breaking that verse up, and we're going to learn it over maybe 2 or 3 weeks, just so that we can all get it into our heads. It's a lovely verse, and we want to thank Stephen for doing the memory verse for us tonight. Now we're going to ask Jacob to come back up again. We're going to sing our next chorus just before Auntie Pauline comes to do our story. And this is a lovely chorus. It was new to us as well when we started up our Beeline on Facebook Live, and this has become another favourite of us, of ours here at the Beeline, and it's I Can Know God. And it starts off, I may not be big, like the mountain so tall, but I can know God who made them all. And you know, boys and girls, that is so true. It doesn't matter how young you are. Some people say children don't understand, they're too young to be saved. That's not true. That's what that little verse says, suffer the little children to come unto me. Allow the children to come. Don't let anybody stop you from coming to the Lord Jesus Christ. Because I was 5 whenever I got saved. My wee sister was 4. And I know of somebody else, my little niece was 3. And my little niece understood it perfectly as well. So you're not too young. If you understand it fully, it doesn't matter what age, you can still come and put your faith and trust in the Lord Jesus Christ. So we're going to sing this lovely little chorus.
I may not be big like the mountain so tall, but I can know God who made them all. I may not be strong like the rivers that flow, but I can know God who makes them go. Yes, I can know God, He's big and strong. Yes, I can know God and sing His song. God loves me so much and wants me to be a child in His own forever family. I could not be there to see Jesus die, but I can know God and understand why. I may not be big or tall or wise, but I can know God made Jesus alive. Yes, I can know God, He's big and strong. Yes, I can know God and sing His song. God loves me so much and wants me to be a child in His own.
That was brilliant, boys and girls. Well done. Thank you so much, Jacob, for being my helper tonight. And you've done a great job, and that's you finished now. And you can go and take a wee seat. But thank you so much, Pat, for coming along and helping us tonight. You can have a wee seat now, Pat. Good boy. That's great. And you know, boys and girls, that chorus just finishes off there. That God loves me so much and He wants me to be a child in His own forever family. And I wonder tonight, boys and girls, your mums and dads, whoever's listening, I wonder, are you part of the family of God? Now we've got some more shout outs here, and then we're going to have Auntie Pauline come on to do our story. Excuse me for stretching away there. So Johnny and Jane Crane say, hello, Auntie Ruth. Hello, Johnny and Jane. Thank you very much for tuning in the whole way from Oma. We've got Chloe Thompson watching. You're very welcome, Chloe. And little Isabel Beggs watching too. It's great to have our wee regulars here from Lurgan watching as well. And then we've got Merle and Derek Owen. You're very welcome as well. And Lauren Rankin. That is brilliant, Lauren. Thank you for tuning in tonight. And we've got Lily Ann Cook and her mummy watching. It's lovely to have you watching in too. We've got Grace, Harry and Alfie Johnson watching, and Olive Clowes. And we're really, really glad to have you, Auntie Olive, watching in as well. Now, we're coming to that most important part of our meeting, where we are going to be learning from the Bible. And it's lovely to have Auntie Pauline with us again tonight. And she's going to teach us our second lesson on the new series that we're doing on children in the Bible. And we're really excited and looking forward to hearing what Auntie Pauline has to say to us. I'm going to hand over to her now. Thank you very much.
Hello, boys and girls. I hope that you're all keeping well. And thank you again for joining in with us tonight. And boys and girls, I'm going to let you into a secret. Do you know the final chorus that we sang there? I want to know God. Well, do you know, that is my favourite chorus. And I have to tell you, I searched and I searched to see if I could find that. And I actually sent an email to Auntie Ruth to see where I could find that. And, you know, I finally found it. And, you know, I go about the house singing that chorus. And I think I have everybody in the house thinking, oh, no, not again that chorus. But that is really my favorite chorus. I think it is really, really a lovely chorus. So I hope away at home that you were all singing that really, really well for me. Now, boys and girls, before we come to the next part in our really, really exciting new series, I want you to do something for me. Do you think you could stand up? Okay, so you're going to stand up really straight, okay, arms at your side. Do you think you could stretch really high? What do you think? You could stretch really way up, okay? What about could you stretch really down low? Could you go really way down? Oh, way, way down. And what about could you stretch way out? Oh, who could stretch way out? Okay, and what about then could you fold your arms? You could, couldn't you? And what are we going to do? We're going to pray and we're going to ask God's help upon our meeting tonight. So what do we do? Fold our arms, which I'm sure they are already folded. We're going to bow our heads and we're going to close our eyes and we're going to pray. Heavenly Father, we do thank thee again for Beeline tonight. We thank thee for the beautiful choruses that we have sang. We thank thee for the memory verse. We thank thee for Jacob and all his actions and singing so well. We thank thee for thy presence with us so far. We pray now as we come to thy word that you'll undertake for us. Come and bless the boys and girls, mums and dads all at home for thy name's sake. Amen. Now, boys and girls, I'm going to test you here tonight. I want you, do you think you could tell me who lives in Buckingham Palace? Maybe you have been on a holiday to London and you've went to Buckingham Palace to have a look at it. Do you know the lady who lives in it? Shout out, who do you think it could be? Could it be Queen Elizabeth II? It is. The Queen lives in Buckingham Palace. But boys and girls, do you know how many kings or queens there have been who have been on the throne in England and in Great Britain? Could you guess a number? How many do you think we have had? Well, do you know, I know somebody who can actually name them all. And do you know how many there is? There's been 61 of them. Okay, so how many we've had? We've got 61. Now, could you name any? Do you think you could name any kings or queens that we've had? Okay, let's see. William the Conqueror? You ever hear about him? Or what about Richard de Lionheart? What about him? You ever heard of him? Or what about Henry VIII? Maybe we've heard a wee bit about him. Or what about William of Orange? We all know about him, don't we? Yeah, he was popular. But boys and girls, what about in your Bible? Can you think, oh, there's Queen Victoria. Forgot about her. She's on our list as well. But boys and girls, what about in God's Word? Can you name any kings in the Bible? There's many kings and queens in the Bible. Maybe you think Esther, who we learnt about over the last few weeks, she's in the Bible. What about, can you think of anybody else? David, Saul, Nebuchadnezzar, or Solomon? Or maybe you could name a whole pile of other kings. But boys and girls, tonight I want us to think about a very young king, and his name was Josiah. And Josiah came to the throne of Judah when he was only 8 years of age. Imagine being the king at only 8. Do you think that would be good, to be the king and to rule at such an early age? But unfortunately for Josiah, when he came to the land and to rule over the land of Judah, Judah was in a terrible condition. Sin was everywhere. The people had turned from following God. They had left the one true and living God, and they had started to follow the false gods. There was images, statues of all these gods all over the place. Even in the house of God, these statues were everywhere. Imagine in the house of God, they had put statues, they put images, and there was priests. And they were all over the land of Judah. Well, this was terrible. And Josiah was not at all happy. But the Bible tells us that Josiah walked in the steps of David, his father, and he done that which was right. Josiah loved God, and he wanted to keep the commandments that he had been taught. And so he was a very brave man, because what did he do? He sent out a command that all these false gods, all these images and statues that were all over the land had to be taken down. They all had to be removed. There could be no false gods, no images, no statues anywhere. Everything had to go. What a brave command Josiah had given. I'm sure there was many people in the land who were not very happy with him, but Josiah was determined to stamp out idolatry in the land of Judah at this time. But boys and girls, when Josiah was 26, he had been on the throne for 18 years, and he noticed that the house of God was getting to be in the need of some repair. It needed to be restored. And so he called for his scribe, Shaphan, and he said to him and some other men, "I want you to repair the temple for me, this house of God. It needs to be repaired. Any money that you need for the repairs, it could come out of the offerings that come into the temple." And so these men, they went and got some builders, some carpenters, some stonemasons, and many people were employed. They went and got the materials, stone and wood, and they started to repair the house of God. And these men faithfully worked on the house of God and started to do all the repairs that were needed. But one day, Hilkiah, the high priest, he was walking in the house of God. He was in the temple, and he found something very, very amazing. It was a scroll. Now, boys and girls, many years ago, before books were printed, everybody wrote on scrolls. Well, this was no ordinary scroll. What was it that Hilkiah had found? He had found the first five books of the Bible. Do you know what the first five books of the Bible are? Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, and Deuteronomy. And boys and girls, Hilkiah had found these five books that God had inspired Moses to write all those years before. But boys and girls, how sad that these scrolls of the five books of the Bible, they had been hidden, some say maybe for 80 years. How sad, boys and girls, that the word of God hadn't been read in the temple. Imagine coming to the house of God and the Bible not been read. The Bible hadn't been read to all those people for so many years. This was a great find. Hilkiah was delighted that he had found the word of God. And so he came and he passed it over to Shaphan the scribe, and he brought it back to Josiah the king. And so what do you think started to happen? The scribe started to read the Bible to Josiah. And as he read through all these first five books of the Bible, he would have read from the book of Exodus, the second book of the Bible. And Exodus tells us of how the children of Israel, they left the land of Egypt, and how they travelled through the wilderness. At times they failed God, they sinned against God, and God punished them. Also in Exodus we read of the commandments. Do you know how many commandments there are? There's 10 commandments, and one of them is, "Thou shalt have no other gods before me." The second one, "Thou shalt not make unto thee any graven image." Well, boys and girls, as Josiah listened, he thought, oh, what had the people of Judah been doing? They had been worshipping graven images. They had set up other gods in the place of the one true God. And Josiah started to think, oh dear, these people have been sinning so badly and disobeying God. Well, Shaphan kept reading to Josiah. But you know, the first five books of the Bible, the law of God, they also teach about God. They teach that God is holy, that God is just, that God is good. But boys and girls, we're not good. What are we? We are sinners. Each one of us, we are born with sin in our hearts. And our sin separates us from God, because God is holy. Well, as the scribe continued to read the word of God to Josiah the king, do you know, Josiah got more and more upset. He became very heartbroken. He became very unhappy. And actually, he started to rent his clothes as a sign that he was so unhappy, because he thought of all the sin of the people. and what they had done, and how they had left God and started to follow these false gods. And so he started to think, well, God punished the children of Israel when they sinned. Was God going to punish the land? What was going to happen to the people of Josiah's land? And so he thought, I'm going to send some people and they inquire of the prophetess. And so Achaim and Abdon and Shaphan, and they all went to see this lady. And this lady was called Huda, and she was a prophetess. And she prayed and she inquired of God to see what God was going to do in the land of Judah, to punish, whether God would punish the people or whether what was going to happen. And so this lady, she prayed and she told the four gentlemen that had come to see her that God had said that yes, he was going to punish the land. The land and the people had disobeyed him. They had sinned. And God, yes, was going to punish them. But God would not punish the land while Josiah was king, because God had saw that Josiah loved God and that he had tried his best to keep the commandments of God, and that he was so sorry for the way the people had sinned in the land. And so the land would have peace till Josiah died. And so these men went back and they told Josiah what the lady had said. And so Josiah called all the people, and all the people came to the house of God. They came to the temple, and Josiah read to them from the Bible, and he read to them from God's law. And all the people, they stood and they listened. And boys and girls, how important it is to come to God's house, to come to God's house and to hear God's word. Boys and girls, as the chorus said, we have a precious book. It is the word of God. And yet, boys and girls, such a precious book, but so often we don't read our Bibles. So often our Bibles are left in the shelf and we don't read our Bibles. And boys and girls, it's so important that we take time to read our Bibles and take time to come to God's house and to hear his word been preached. And so Josiah spoke to all the people and read to them from the law of God that day. That day Josiah said, and he promised that he would obey God and keep his commandments. The people, they promised as well that they would obey God and keep the commandments as well. But unfortunately, the people, they didn't keep their promise, because as soon as Josiah died, the people went back to their sinful and willful ways. Well, not only that day did Josiah bring all the people to hear the law of God, he also made sure that anybody that had encouraged others to worship false gods were put out of the land. Josiah was determined that these false prophets and this false religion wasn't going to be in his land. And so he got rid of anybody that had encouraged others. Also, any statues or images or anything that was against the law of God was continually taken out of the land of Judah. He also encouraged the people to remember the Passover. And the Passover was a time when the children of Israel lived in the land of Egypt, and how they'd been slaves to the Pharaoh and the people there, and how they had wanted to leave that land, but Pharaoh wouldn't let them go. And so God had sent 10 plagues. And then the last plague, the Lord Jesus had told the people that they had to take a lamb that had no spots, that it was a good lamb. They had to keep it for 14 days, and in the 14th day, they had to kill the lamb. And the lamb, the blood of the lamb was to be put on the top of the doors and round the side of the door. And that night, the death angel was to come over the land of Egypt. And you know, if the death angel didn't see the blood upon the door, then the firstborn in that house would die. And boys and girls, the Jews in Judah at that time, they had to remember what God had done that time in Egypt. And this was a time of thanking God for his deliverance from the land of Egypt. And boys and girls, you and I have so much to be thankful for. As these Jewish people had so much to thank God for how he had delivered them. And you and I have so much to be thankful for. We've got food, we've got clothing, we've got homes, we have families that love us. We have so much. Boys and girls, most of all, we have what has God done for you and for me, that he sent his son, his only beloved son, to die on the cross, to shed his blood for you and for me. We have so much to thank God for. And boys and girls, do we take time to thank God for all that he has done for us? Because he has done so, so very, very much. You know, boys and girls, Josiah was a great king. There was no king that came after him like him. He was young when he came to the throne, but what a difference he made in that land of Judah. Josiah loved the Lord from an early age. And you know, he served God with all his soul, his heart, and his mind. And you know, God used him in a mighty, mighty way. And boys and girls, the God that used Josiah in a mighty, mighty way, that God can use you and God can use me. But boys and girls, you and I need to come. We need to come and give our hearts and our lives to the Lord Jesus. And if we do that, then the Lord Jesus will use us. Just as the Lord Jesus used this 8-year-old that came to the throne, that took a stand and stood up for God and the commandments that God had given him. And boys and girls, tonight, I hope that you will be a Josiah, that you will take your stand for God. And boys and girls, if you know not him, that you will come and give your heart and your life to the Lord Jesus. Now, boys and girls, thank you all so much for setting up and listening so well. You've been absolutely amazing. Before Auntie Ruth's going to come back, we're going to close our eyes, we're going to fold our arms, bow our heads, and close our eyes again. Heavenly Father, we do thank thee for thy presence with us tonight. We thank thee for the story of Josiah and for the stand that he took against idolatry and false gods all in the land. We pray that indeed we will take a stand for thee, that we will stand up, that we will read our Bibles, and for any at home that know not thee, that they will come and trust in thee. For thy name's sake. Amen. Thank you, boys and girls, once again. You've been absolutely great.
Thank you so much, Auntie Pauline, for doing the story for us tonight. I thoroughly enjoyed that. I love the story of Josiah in the Bible, and just hearing it just again, freshly now, I just thoroughly enjoyed it. So I want to thank you so much, Auntie Pauline. And I hope, boys and girls, and whoever's watching in, that you take that all in. And boys and girls, if you're saved, don't be afraid to take your stand for the Lord Jesus Christ. Josiah was only 8 years old whenever he became king, and look how he took his stand the whole way through his reign. And boys and girls, you can do the same. Don't be thinking, I'm too young. I'm sure there are lots of boys and girls who are watching in tonight, and they are the same age or around the same age as what Josiah was when he became king. So don't be thinking, boys and girls, I can't do anything for God. God can use you. He can use you in your own home. He can use you at school. And you just pray and ask the Lord Jesus Christ to use you. And may he make you boys and girls of prayer. Boys and girls, you can pray. And that is really, really important. And you never know, whenever you become older, you could become a missionary or a minister and do a work for the Lord. And if you're not saved, that is our desire and our prayer here at the Beeline, to see boys and girls and adults all come to the Saviour. We don't want to see you lost. We want to see you saved and in God's family. So we want to thank Auntie Pauline again. We want to thank all you for watching. And we have just a few more shout-outs here to do before we say goodnight. We've got Igor's. Thank you very much, Igor's, for tuning in tonight. We've got Uncle John and Auntie Frances tuning in from Facebook or from Sermon Audio. We're delighted to have you watching in. And they say that Beeline is very special. And it is very special, I have to say, too. And I'm sure all the workers would agree with that. And we'll have Julie Taylor watching in the whole way from 6 Mile Cross on Sermon Audio 2. Thank you very much, Julie, for taking the time to join with us tonight as well. And we have Wee Charlie and Summer Savage, too. And it's lovely to have you watching in as well. And then I know my very good friends, Mr. and Mrs. Sam and Elizabeth Gardner, are also watching in. And we want to welcome them to the Beeline tonight. And thank you for taking the time to join us. Thank you all so much for taking the time to join with us tonight. It really is just such a joy and a delight to be able to share a Wednesday night with you, and we thank you for taking the time to be with us. We want to invite you to come back next week. Don't forget about our Easter service next week, whenever the Reverend Garth Wilson will be along to take that service. So don't forget to tune in. I know schools are off, but don't forget, Beeline is not off next week. Or maybe schools aren't off next week, I can't remember. But anyway, don't forget to tune in to Beeline next week. We're just going to finish off with a lovely wee song tonight, just as we leave you, and it's called 'Tis So Sweet to Trust in Jesus. And this is a hymn that we would sing on a Sunday in our own church, and also it is a little hymn, a chorus, that we have started to sing here at the Beeline online. So if you've been tuning in these last number of weeks, you will recognise this little song, but it is beautiful. The words of it are really lovely, and we hope boys and girls and mums and dads and whoever else is listening in that you will take the time to just sit back and enjoy this little song. And it is so true, it is so sweet to trust in Jesus. Good night.